We're testing the effect of pitching on the shoulder and the elbow of youth athletes. We're looking for how the arm is moving, so we're looking at our shoulder and elbow angles. We're also looking at kinetics, so we're looking at shoulder forces and torques, as well as elbow forces and torques, to see how those elbow forces and torques and shoulder forces and torques match up with our ultrasound data.
That's the ball. The socket is actually over here. So this right here is likely one of your rotator cuff tendons, and then up here you've got muscle.
Theoretically, what happens is the arm adapts to throwing. When we throw over a period of time, our muscles and our ligaments adapt. And not only our muscles and ligaments, but we forget sometimes that our bone adapts as well. And what we're looking for on the ultrasound is to see whether one side, really their throwing side, adapts more than the other side. What we've seen typically is that our professional baseball players have these large shoulder and elbow adaptations. Our high school players do have some of those adaptations, but they don't have as much adaptation we would see side to side. We haven't run any of the data on mechanics to see how that affects anything, but that's really the goal of the study.